You might be wondering which tool you should use for a project. Now, some of the tools are better for beginners, some of them are great at prototyping, and some are really meant for experienced developers. I'm going to use two of them, Bolt as well as Cursor. Bolt is several steps beyond using a chatbot, and it's going to give me a great starting template. What Bolt does best is prototype a concept and then give you a fantastic starting point. That's going to be more difficult for a tool like Cursor, which is really meant more for professionals. It's by far the most popular vibe coding tool out there. To get started, I'm going to use this data file right here. It's a set of performance metrics. You'll be able to find this data in the repository for this course. Let's add this to Bolt so it has context as to what I want to do. And then I'm going to start with a simple question. I'll just say, create a dashboard for analyzing this data, and then I'll hit send. Bolt has a number of pre-built templates, and it's going to create a project by analyzing our data and then building a great-looking dashboard. Most of the time, Bolt is going to use a React project, and it knows how to create those really well. The thing about vibe coding is that no two sessions will be the same, even if you type exactly what I did in this course. The AI models take a bit of creative license when coding, so it's okay to start a new session if you don't get something you love. As Bolt vibe codes, you can actually see what it's doing here on the right-hand side. And you can click on some of these files and see how it codes the different components. It looks like it's done with the application. And you can see that it did a pretty decent job with the data analysis. And it was even able to give me a light or dark mode version. Of course, I can ask Bolt to continue designing and modifying this project. But I want to show you how it pairs well with most professional tools like Cursor. So to do that, I'm going to hit this export button and just download the file into my local computer. And it'll be here in my desktop. So we're now done with Bolt. So I'll go ahead and close that window. And I'm going to decompress this file. I'm going to rename this Vibe Coding. And I'll open this up in Cursor. Now, when you first open up Cursor, you'll see that there is a new chat section right here, which is where you're going to do most of your prompting. If that is not showing up, then click right here on this toggle AI pane section. And there's a few other things that you may want to check before you begin. First off, you may want to choose the model that you want to use for your projects. You can have Cursor automatically pick a model for you by clicking on this auto select section. You can also choose to look at only the thinking models or pick whatever you want yourself. I'm sticking with Claude 3.5 Sonnet. It'll work really well with this project. The other thing that you may want to check is whether you want it to work in agentive mode, which means that it will do most of the changes automatically. You can also tell it to ask you whether or not you want to implement the changes, and then it will just give you suggestions and let you pick whether or not you want to approve those changes. I'm going to leave it in agent mode. You may also want to check the Cursor specific settings. Cursor is a copy of Visual Studio Code, which should look familiar to most developers, but it has its own settings. You can access them right here. The most important thing you want to check is, of course, your list of models. This tab will control which models show up in this dropdown. There are some models that have the name Max in them. These models will cost more, so I like to turn those off. You can also use your own API keys if you've got them. However, those may make some custom features not work. The other place that you want to look at is this rules section. This is where you would add anything that you want the project to always consider. Think of them as system instructions, and you can do those for all your projects by putting them in this user rules or create a rule for the specific project. Because I have quite a comprehensive project that Bolt has already created for me, I don't want any of my rules to fight what it's already done. So I'm going to leave those alone. So I'm going to go ahead and start by asking it to help me preview this code. So first, it's going to look at the entire code base. And in this case, it's going to run npm install and npm run dev and run a server for you. So you can command click to open that up. And here's what that social media dashboard looks like. Overall, I think it did a pretty good job, but I think my performance trends could be a little bit better. So I'm going to ask it to modify that. I'm going to say, can you modify the performance trends section? I want to see the video names when I roll over them and would prefer a stacked line chart. It's going to automatically make some suggestions and you can review them right here and accept any changes individually. And normally, if it changed multiple files, you would see accept all right here. But because it's only one file, it says accept. I'll go ahead and say yes. It doesn't look like it's automatically updated. And sometimes it won't let you refresh this. Somehow it stops the server from running. I'm going to pretend I don't know that. And I'll just say I can't see the preview. Now it started the server again. So I'm going to click on this server. And you can see that when I roll over these, it's showing me some of the information. Sometimes I make the mistake of trying to explain to Cursor in natural language how to make a visual change when it's just a lot easier to include a screenshot. So I'm going to take a screenshot and I'm going to let it know that when I roll over, I can't see the entire graph. So I'll take a screenshot here. I'm using a tool called Snagit. So it has this nice way of adding little arrows so I can point to what I'm talking about here. And I'll go ahead and add this as context into Cursor and notice that it loaded up an image. That's a really useful thing to do when you want to tell the model something that is more easily understood visually. And it looks like once again, it lost track of its live reload. So this time I'm going to open up a terminal and just run the npm run def command myself over here. That way, hopefully it won't be based on whatever is on this chat. All right, let's go to the other window and we'll refresh this. And now I can see everything a little bit better. Now, I really would like to see some sort of line drawings here. So let's try taking another screenshot just of this section. And once again, I'm going to go into my little tool here and ask it to sort of draw some of the lines, something like this. And I'll move this in. All right, let's see if that's working a little better. I do like these open dots better, but I'm not sure it's actually giving me lines. So let me try one more time. I'll ask it to try recreating that chart from scratch. All right, let's take a look at what it did. And now the data doesn't look right at all. Every once in a while, you're going to have to roll back to a previous checkpoint. I do like when it got to this section here. So I'm going to restore this checkpoint and I'll modify this message right here. I'll say, change this to a bar chart. And I actually think that's a lot better. I'm going to try asking it to just stack this information. Still looks horrible. Can you try stacking the text information? That is looking really nice now, although I would like these dates to be a little bit more underneath. Let's go ahead and grab another screenshot really quick. This time I'm going to put my handy dandy arrows to these dates right here. I'll say, can you move these dates down a bit? All right, let's take a look. That looks a lot better. And my rollovers look fantastic. I do like the light and dark mode, but I'm noticing that whenever I refresh my screen, it kind of resets to light mode. I normally work in dark mode anyways, so I'm going to have it detect the mode of the computer and see if it can use local storage so that it can remember between refreshes. I'll say, I noticed that if I switch to dark mode and refresh the page, it goes back to light mode. Can you make the page read the computer's mode and remember it between reloads? All right, let's check it out. My computer is set to dark mode by default, and I'm going to refresh, and it is maintaining the dark mode. So that's great. I'm going to switch over to light mode. And if I refresh, it is maintaining the light mode. So that's awesome. I'll leave it in dark mode because that's what I like. The graphs still look pretty good. I'm going to see if I can create a separate tab that has all the posts. I don't need all that in this page. So I'm going to ask it to maybe create another tab right here. I'll say, can you create some tabs to move the all posts section and let me toggle between the dashboard with all the graphs and all the posts. All right, let's take a look at the page. And now, although it didn't put them up here, I think it's fine. It put them right over here. If I scroll, I can see that it doesn't have all the post information down here. And I can toggle between this page that has all the post information and the main dashboard with all of the data. Let's go ahead and ask if it can add a few more charts. I'll say, can you add a few more charts now that you have more room under performance trends? And it did a few more charts. I'm not sure that I like this metrics legend. So let's see if we can switch it out to show me some information about the duration. I'll say, can you switch out the metrics legend to something that displays interesting information about the watched time? All right, let's see what it did. That isn't exactly what I was looking for, but I think this is actually a lot better than what I had in mind. I probably spend a few hours overall in my vibe coding session, trying out different things. Remember to stay loose with your prompts. Don't ask it to do too much. Include screenshots. And sometimes you'll have to deal with errors and revert to previous points. Vibe coding is all about going with the flow.